Power Jam!
Hi there, and welcome to day two of the Men's Roller Derby World Cup. My name's Dan Glewitz, and I'm here today, and we'll be popping in and out as the day goes on, just to bring you some updates and be able to do some interviews. With me today is one of our analysts, Andy, and we're going to talk through in a moment the structure of the rest of the day and what we've seen so far from the tournament. Thanks very much for joining us here on live.mrdwc.com. We're going to be going over to the action on the Roller Derby City track in a little while, but if you've been tuning in before on the Quad Skate Shop track, you'll have already seen our fantastic expo bout, which was brilliant to see. Team USA plus Finland versus Wales plus friends, and able to get some fantastic action in even this early in the morning. Also, you've just seen a fabulous countdown, and in my head, we couldn't hear that, but I was hearing like wham, wham. So I hope you were getting that too. So Andy, obviously we've had the first day. We'll have a look at the tables in just a second, but what does that first day look like, and what does that mean for the second day?
I think we saw yesterday there's the traditional big guns, so the USA, Canada, England were very impressive. They won very convincingly, but they also conceded some points. So we're starting to see some chinks in their armour. We saw some really impressive performances from Team Japan, who've been the real talking point of this year. They've just been absolutely fabulous. They've taken the spirit of Derby, the trophy itself is named the Spirit of Derby, and they've really embodied that. They were excellent yesterday. You're going to be seeing them first up on the track today. Ireland were great yesterday. Argentina were a real surprise package. They were strong, they were agile, they've got a real mix of power and pace. You'll be seeing them today as well. And Team Australia and France, we've got a matchup coming there. They look very, very strong. I think that's going to be one of the highlights of the day. But they were all strong yesterday. They all made some really impressive debuts in this World Cup.
It's great. And speaking of Team Japan, I've heard it best phrased saying that Team Japan is the only team at the moment with 200 bench coaches surrounding them. A fantastic moment during one of the bouts yesterday where the Japanese jammer managed to lose his helmet cover. And I swear, everybody in the hall was screaming at him to go back and get it so he could start scoring points. Really, this crowd has got behind Japan. And as you say, Argentina coming with eight guys to this tournament and really kicking some behind as they do it.
They were fabulous. I mean, you often find that if you've got that small number on track, everyone gels together and everyone really gets onto the game very, very quickly. And we found that with Argentina. They were strong against England. They made a good start there. They just blew Sweden away. They were absolutely incredible in that game. And the final game as well against Netherlands, they were really, really strong. They've surprised a lot of people with the quality of their skating. Also the strategy. They've got some really big blockers, but they've got some very small, tiny, nippy jammers who are going to be difficult. We're going to see them later today against France, I believe. That's going to be a really strong matchup. France, of course, have got Monsieur Furio, Killian David, as he's skating under at the moment. It's going to be a really interesting clash of styles, I think.
Yeah, I think you're absolutely right. We might be able to have a look at the tables right now for you, right there on your screens, you can see. Andy, talk us through what those tables actually mean for today. So how do those tables translate into the action you're going to see on the tracks?
Okay, well, the key things, you've got the top two of every division. They're progressing through to the next qualifying rounds. You've got a mixture of games today. So you've got some of the consolation places being sorted out, and the first game you're going to see is going to be Ireland against Japan, Belgium and Germany, and then Finland against Sweden. Then the really heavy stuff starts. So you can see that in the orange group, Canada and Scotland made it through. In the blue group, France and Australia. Green, we have England and Argentina. And the red group, we've got the USA and Wales. They're going through to the quarterfinals today. And they start around about 12:30 GMT, which is going to be 8:30 Eastern Standard Time for you Americans there. And that's going to start with France against Argentina. So the big four games that you're going to see today, France, Argentina, Canada, Wales, England, Australia, and the USA against Scotland. You're going to see a lot of other quality derby, though. Highlights for me are going to be the first game, Ireland against Japan. Ireland very unlucky yesterday. Japan crowd favourites, going to be a fabulous atmosphere here. You can already hear it building just over to my left. There's going to be some great stuff going on. You really need to stick with it throughout the course of the day. The big game starts at 12:30 GMT, but the quality derby starts straight away.
That's great. It's also worth bearing in mind that as we go through today, although the elimination stages have started, only three teams that are skating today will not be skating tomorrow. So even tomorrow, we're going to have the vast majority of your teams still here. We're about to go over to the action now on the Royal Derby City track, where we're going to see, I think it's fair to say, actually, the most anticipated matchup so far, Ireland versus Japan. I can't actually see how any of the crowd are going to survive this one, because these teams really do have a lot of support going on. We're going to go straight over to that action now on the Royal Derby City track. Stick with us as we go through the day, and thanks very much for tuning in.
And it's good morning from me, Holly Sheet. I am so actually stoked now to actually get to announce one of Ireland's games. I've been looking forward to doing the announcing for this team all weekend. Some players on the track who haven't been part of the national teams here at the World Cup, which was fantastic to be able to see again the level and the standard of play from the skaters who aren't making their national teams, but it's still so high. And it's just brilliant, as you said, slightly showy offy, but we love that especially in the men's roller derby, seeing all the spins and the jumps that they throw in.
There was even a couple of little apex jumps. I was a happy snooker right there.
Yeah, lots of big hits. Oh, fantastic. We've just been told Seahorses Forever came from the USA just for that exhibition.
Wow.
And he was playing on odd skates for half of it as well.
Yeah, that was that couldn't have been easy. We, Sven and myself, spotted him a couple of times having some skate issues. We think it may have been his axles. So he switched out, was on the old odd skates. There was one sort of tan colour skate, one white skate. Seemed to manage to fix that later on in the game because he was back on his own skates, but that's absolutely incredible that he came all the way over here just for the expo.
It's absolutely fantastic, wonderful to see. Okay, on the track right now, warming up, we do have the Team Ireland. Let me just read out their roster for you. We have number 1000 El Haraya, number 117 Justin Ballsteve, number 45 Ab Norman, number 42 Lieutenant Dan, number 51 Kian Brennan, number 7, Wallbanger. Number 75, Errol Flynn. Number 8, 008, Eddie Knievel. Number 82, Mick Dastardly. Number 9, I Play for Keeps. Number 981, Cuban Whistle Crisis. Number B52, Block Lobster. And number F34R, Electrics Avenue. Number 904, Wave and Buster, is still injured, so won't be taking part in the game here this morning. When we get some details about his injury, as I said, we will try and get those to you as soon as we can.
Absolutely. We do wish him a very speedy recovery, and we've got all our fingers crossed that it's a really easily fixable thing.
We hope so indeed. He was taken care of immediately by the GB EMS team. They came straight out to him, spent some time with him yesterday, and made sure he was taken off for all the full care that he needed.
Yeah, I've been to a lot of bouts where GB EMS have been present, and they are always absolutely professional. They are wonderful.
They are indeed. Fantastic to see them. They do sponsor over here on the Roller Derby City track, the pivot line. So I know not a lot of starts have been taking place on that pivot line, but it does mean we get to see it nice and shiny.
Absolutely.
On the track. So thank you to GB EMS. There's a lot of love in the crowd as the Japanese team do take to the track here. for their warm-up. I'm sure you can probably hear it over our feed microphones as much as anything else. This is going to be a loud audience participation game, I believe. There's a huge amount of love and support for the Japanese team. They have stolen the hearts of every fan here today and the fans on Twitter. But I can still see a sea of green out in the audience, so I do think this is going to be one of the loudest games. Even this bright and early on the Saturday morning, there is a absolute shed load of people here, which is fantastic to see.
You can see on our feed there's a couple of ladies in the front row with some wonderful, wonderful...
leprechaun hats.
Thank you. The word evaded me. Them mighty fine hats.
It is St. Patrick's Day on Monday.
Of course.
And Birmingham has one of the largest St. Patrick's Day events outside of Ireland.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so a lot of people who are coming over for the weekend, especially the Irish, are planning to stay. We will, of course, be celebrating St. Patrick's Day here at the World Cup tomorrow. So there will be lots of people in the fantastic leprechaun hats, the little zagabongs, all the wonderful greenery. But I know a lot of people are staying for the Monday as well to celebrate here in Birmingham.
Fantastic. It's times like this you realise that actually it's pretty easy being green.
It is indeed, especially if you are Team Ireland. They've had a fantastic turnaround in this tournament as well. They didn't win in the France game that they had, but they have won their other games too. So they've done some really good job. I watched the Ireland-Germany game yesterday, later on in yesterday evening. And they really did prove themselves a force. That was the game that did have to be called off early due to injury. But it was a really good play from Ireland up until that point.
And I can tell you, last weekend, Team Ireland headed over to Milton Keynes and faced off against the Milton Keynes men's team, the Quads of War. Can I tell you, that is probably the most tense game I have ever announced. I'm in the region of 50-something bouts I've announced now, probably close to 100 that I've seen, and it was the first time I ever witnessed a tie, an overtime jam.
Fantastic.
It was absolutely phenomenal.
It was indeed. I just was catching up on all of the feeds online. It was brilliant. I know that the boys themselves, having that chance to get together, they played a couple of games before coming over to this tournament, and they really did appreciate being able to come over and get that experience. Yeah.
They were absolutely on form, and they really gave the quads a run for their money.
They did indeed. Whereas on the flip side, the Japanese team, not having that much experience before coming into the tournament, I believe most of them, the majority of them, only started realising the actual game of roller derby and how it is played in December of 2013. So they've only had a few months to get themselves up to speed with the rest of the world. It does show in some of their gameplay. They're probably not as aware of the rules as other teams are, but as you said, their skill and their absolute love and passion for what they're doing shows across, and as we said, the audience are behind them in every game that they're playing.
Yeah, I actually saw a fact yesterday, hashtag true derby fact, hashtag MRDWC. The gentlemen playing for Team Japan represent all of the male roller derby players in Japan.
In the whole of Japan.
They are it.
Those 11 skaters, that's all that Japan has to offer for men's roller derby, and each and every one of them has made their way over.
Those guys, of course, playing today, we have number one, who is Yutu. 113 is Gonzi. 136, Zoro. 18. 1929, DJ Jack. 32, I apologise, I'm probably going to say this wrong,
Ikajisoyaro.
We'll try really hard for that one. Number 4, Ryoshin. Number 7, Umesan. Number 99, Bubble. And R4,
Mayugi Bondai.
Mayugi Bondai.
Good morning, Birmingham.
Mayugi,
are you ready for day two of the Men's Roller Derby World Cup?
Okay, taking part. We will be
okay, so this is going to be game one.
For each of the teams.
Fantastic.
Ninja so Pan versus Team Ireland.
Silent for a while. We are going silent for the national anthems. You should have sound coming through to you over the feed, and you won't have any discussion from.
And of course, this is the first of our regulation.
We do have
two period bouts
to be upstanding for the national anthems. We will be encouraging it here at the venue. I think we'll probably stand up as well.
I most certainly will, otherwise my parents will lynch me for the Irish one. Ireland today playing in that very, very dark green with the white striping, and Japan playing in their white and red tops with red shorts. They will be identified with as the white team by the looks of it. So Japan in white, Ireland in green. Lieutenant Dan, I got you some ice cream.
Aww.
Fantastic. We all need a little bit of ice cream.
Little fact for you, ladies and gentlemen. Japan, they actually wear full body armor under their kit. They are ninjas.
They are indeed.
Right, ladies and gentlemen, can you all please be upstanding for the national anthem of Japan?
Spoken to you in Japanese, you can jump over to the alt language feed and join Robert Rodriguez, who will guide you through.
It's absolutely fantastic. Okay, we are just heading over now to the national anthems. National anthems for both countries are going to be played. So loudly that we could hear him at the opposite end of the track.
And
so
now, remain upstanding for the national anthem of Ireland.
Proving that this is indeed the International Men's Roller Derby World Cup. Each team will get the chance to have their national anthem played today for their first game that they have today. So if a team plays twice, I believe they're only getting the national anthem the first time that they play.
That is also as I understand it.
Okay, teams are lined up now on the track, ready to start off. We have team captain number 45, Ab Norman, taking the Jammer Star for Team Ireland. And for Japan, we have R4, Magayu Bondai, on the jammer line.
And up to jam for Team Ireland, it is number 45, Ab Norman.
Take a quick moment to tell you that this jam is being brought to you. The whole track is being sponsored by Roller Derby City, Europe's largest supplier of roller derby kit and merchandise. Okay, and Magayu Bondai being recycled all the way to the back by the Ireland team, allowing Ab Norman the chance to take Lee Jammer. He's coming back round now for his scoring pass. Magayu Bondai still being held back, tripping almost over his own player. Ab Norman now being held in the pack, spun around by the Japanese defensive blockers. He is picking up points though and does manage to pass all, and the Jammer picking up a 5-point grand slam.
Magayu Bondai fighting hard against that wall of green. Justin B and Cuban Whistle Crisis taking him off just at that last turn and recycling him halfway back around the track.
Ab Norman has been taken out twice now by the Japanese defensive blockers. They're doing an amazing job of keeping him on that outside line. He's been recycled back twice. However, Magayu Bondai has also been recycled further back than Ab Norman, so both jammers now fighting their way through the pack. Magayu Bondai just breaking the front now for his initial pass. Ab Norman picking up a few more points and pulling the jam off there. And again, the crowd already on this first jam, absolutely enthralled by the level of activity from both the jammers and the blockers. Score stands at Ireland, 10 points, Japan yet to score.
Up to jam now for Japan, it is U2, and up for Ireland is Lieutenant Dam. Jam is on Lieutenant Dam, favouring the out to the inside. U2 managed to slip around the outside, get lead jammer status, but Lieutenant Dam is hot on his trail.
Indeed, Lieutenant Dan aiming for that inside line, but U2 just slightly stronger, pushing him out of the way and forcing his way around to the outside, facing that back wall. Lieutenant Dan recycled all the way to the back. U2 picking up the first points for Japan, 4 points scored there. Lieutenant Dan, however, offering an equal amount of points in reply. U2 being held down by his own blocker, knocked to the outside by Ireland's, as Lieutenant Dan skips his way through.
U2 getting called for a cut track major, means he will spend 1 minute in the quad skate shop penalty box. Lieutenant Dan now on a power jam for Ireland.
Indeed, and that action took place right in front of the crowd. We can hear all of the reactions. Crowd not too pleased with the penalty for Japan, but we do have, obviously, the Ireland supporters quite happy that there's a power jam so early on in the game.
Absolutely.
I do, of course, apologise if I do keep referring to it as a game. I am an active roller derby skater and trying to get my head around the new rules. This is, of course, a bout being played under the 2013 rule set,
yes,
and not a game being played under the 2014 April the 1st rule set. Lieutenant Dan trying to get his way through there. He had some wonderful offensive play by his offensive blocker, Ab Norman. Trying to break up the outside there. That Japanese wall now standing very solid as Lieutenant Dan comes back around. It's Block Lobster breaking it through there for him. Japan's jammer is now standing. Lieutenant Dan taking a quick glance over to see what he wants to do, but he's allowing it to go on. Japan trying to call it off as they exit the penalty box. Of course, they are not eligible to call it off once lead jammer has been sent to the box.
That jam reaching its natural conclusion there. Japan managed to pick up a couple of points when they re-entered the pack. Score ends on that jam. 6 points to Japan, 43 to Ireland.
And we have number 981, Cuban Whistle Crisis, on the jammer line for Ireland.
And up for Japan, it is Zorro.
Team Ireland starting with a blocker in the box. They have the disadvantage. Zorro trying to maximise that, but Cuban Missile Crisis going around the outside, picking up lead jammer. Zorro trying to force his way through that inside line, being recycled back by iPlay for keeps number 9.
Cuban Missile Crisis making his way around that on his first scoring pass seriously fast, coming into the back of the pack. Opportunity now for a natural grand slam, and he gets that.
Does indeed. There's some nifty footwork there from number 4, Ryu Chin, trying to hold back Cuban Missile Crisis, but unfortunately just being spun around. And we do have a penalty being called on the Japanese jammer.
I believe that was a forearms for Zorro being sent to the box.
So again, another power jam here. Let's see if Cuban Missile Crisis can maximise it. He's already had quite a few natural grand slams. His bench, Jessica Ramit, just telling him, carry on playing. Okay. Cuban Missile Crisis being held back, but not quite pushed out by the front row. Japanese blocker there, realising his mistake, puts his hands to his head. Island now have their 4 wall blockers at the back, ready to play some offence. Eddie Knievel going in for that offensive play, trying to make some room for Cuban Missile Crisis. No pack was called. Japan had to let Cuban Missile Crisis go through, and he does pick up another 5-point pass.
Eddie Knievel being sent to the box. I believe that was a blocking out of play.
Okay. And 1929 DJ Jack for Japan also being sent to the box. Also blocking out of play in that no-pack situation. Another 5-point grand slam for Cuban Missile Crisis. The audience are behind him. That's bringing Ireland's score now up to 68 points. Japan still remain on 6 points. And with just over 6 minutes gone in this game, this is a full hour-long bout today. So there will be a half-time break, and the penalties are up to the traditional 7 penalties allowed.
It looks like Zorro, right at the end of that jam there, may have been pretty close to finishing his penalty. And it looks like he went to exit the box. Time had not been finished served, so he has been issued another penalty.
Oh dear.
Meaning that Ab Norman will start this jam on another power jam for Ireland.
I think, again, there might be some of a little bit of translation issues with Team Japan. I know, like we said, they have struggled to catch up with the rules, but done a formidable job in picking it up this weekend.
Most definitely.
And obviously, if he thought he had his allowance to leave the penalty box. Ab Norman here now taking that power jam. Darting his way through that Ireland team, splitting up the Japanese blockers, allowing Ab Norman an easy ride up that inside line on the apex there.
Both teams, of course, with 3 blockers on track, 1 block each in the box. Things a little bit easier there for Ab Norman as he comes round. Japan now on a pack advantage, 2 Irish blockers on track, 2 in the box. Justin B heading to the box right now.
Okay, and we've just been informed that number 1929, DJ Jack for Japan, was actually taking himself to the box by accident. He wasn't aware that he wasn't being sent off the track. He took himself off to the box for a penalty that he didn't actually need to serve.
That then a clarification of what we understood the situation to be. We were incorrect, but we have sorted that all out for you folks. Ab Norman now picking up another 5-point pass.
Japan's blockers trying to take him on one by one. He's just pushing them out of the way. So they're back together in a 3 wall. Number 99, Bubble, forward facing, trying to stop him there.
Zorro back on track, unseen by most of Team All Ireland.
Manages to stay on his inside edges as he works his way up that outside line, just around Mick Dastardly. Ab Norman coming through round to the back of the pack now, facing up against the 2 wall Japanese blockers. Zorro darting his way around on his sides, around the 2 wall of Ireland, picking up some more points there for Team Japan.
That was some beautiful skating there by Zorro. Slipping around the outside, some real sideways skating.
And they do say that they are the Japan are the Japanese team. They definitely showed some ninja skills there by coming back out from the box completely unseen.
Absolutely. U2 and Lieutenant Dam up to jam now. 21 minutes left to play in this half. Japan 10 points, Ireland 93.
And a little bit of a knock from Lieutenant Dam sending U2 to the outside line, giving Lieutenant Dam a little bit of an advantage to take lead jammer status. U2 being recycled back by Ireland's blocker Electrics Avenue.
Lieutenant Dan with an apex jump on turn two.
And U2 just making his way around Block Lobster. He's now broken the pack. He is ready to come round and score some more points. Lieutenant Dan picking up another 5-point grand slam. Oh, and just not allowing Japan the time. They were ready to force some steady opposition offensive play there. They looked like they were picking out the two island blockers one by one. But just not enough time to get on there and get some more points.
This next jam is brought to you by Fast Girl Skates. Fast Girl Skates offers unparalleled expertise, customer service, and fast economical shipping. Visit them at fastgirlskates.com for league and military discounts.
We have number 981, Cuban Whistle Crisis, on the line, picking up lead jammer for Team Ireland. Oh, and Ireland's Mayugi Bondi, unfortunately, picking up a cut track penalty. So again, Ireland's Cuban Whistle Crisis on another power jam. He was so strong in the last one. And again, proves his point here. Able to not only use his agility, but also his strength in just pushing Japan's blockers out of the way. Team Ireland taking the passive defense here. They're not doing much more, letting Cuban Whistle Crisis face up the opposition on his own.
Yeah, Ireland taking the passive offence, but being so quick on that mark to reform when that out-of-play call is called for that no-pack.
Yeah, very, very solid on that passive offence. Cuban Whistle Crisis again back around. He does have a little bit of an assist there from, I believe it is Ab Norman. Jumping over a down skater, able to stay on his feet. Again, picking up 5 points there for Team Ireland. Team Ireland now breaking the 100-point score barrier.
40 seconds left in this jam.
Cuban Whistle Crisis pushing his way through, forcing a no-pack, just allowing himself a little bit of space. Calling it off there just as Japan's jammer stands in the box. So again, Ireland will get the chance to start on a power jam.
And first up to jam today, first time to jam today, sorry, it's Block Lobster for Ireland, B52.
Ireland benefiting from a full lineup now. They've played the last couple of jams with just two blockers on the track, so they've got four blockers and a power jam. Let's see if they can use that to their advantage. Scores are 122 to Ireland, 10 to Japan. Oh, and unseen! Mayugi Bondi again, the ninja from the box. Ireland didn't see him coming. He just quite easily slipped through that wall at the back.
Yep, right in the middle of the pack. Just, he saw that gap and he went for it.
They were caught unawares yet again. However, Block Lobster manages to push his way through and call it off before Mayugi Bondi can pick up any points for Team Japan.
Just as Block Lobster was coming through the pack there, he came up face to face with Uma-san for Japan. It looked like he was hitting a brick wall. He is a solid, solid blocker.
He is indeed.
Zoro and Ab Norman now up to jam. 17, just under 17 and a half minutes left. 126 to Ireland, 10 to Japan. Zoro getting in there with that shoulder straight off the jammer line.
It's being held by a very solid Ireland wall as Ab Norman pushes his way up one-on-one. Manages to force his way through for lead jammer status. Zoro is being sent to the penalty box. He's not quite sure how he's supposed to go. He's just asking a little bit of advice from both his bench and from the referee. Finally does make his way back into the penalty box. Still unsure about what he's supposed to do. Being sent around. Yeah. I think he entered incorrectly.
Yeah, so it looks like he passed the point of no return. So he does have to go all the way around. But he is powering round. Obviously knowing that his time doesn't start until he sits in the box.
In the meantime, Ab Norman has picked up a 5-point power jam pass. And darts around, downs skaters to make sure he picks up another 5 points for Team Ireland. Again, Umi-san at the front trying to control Japan's blockers. We know he's a solid blocker. He's trying to hold himself in as the last line of defence. But Ab Norman quite happily taking them on one at a time.
Japan now up to a full bank of four blockers.
Yeah, with Gundam returning from the penalty box. Ab Norman using that time before they get the full four blockers to pick up another five-point pass before calling it off. Justin B on the jam line for Team Ireland. This jam is being brought to you by Green Monster Roller Sports. All new, visit us today at greenmonster.com.
Justin B taking things slow and steady, coming up against that solid wall of Japanese blockers at the front.
Again, Ireland playing that passive defence, but watching very carefully for the referee signal so that they can reform the pack without getting any penalties. Justin B now on his way back around for a scoring pass. Japan's jammer is standing. Ireland are, of course, trying to pull back and make Japan's jammer come as far back around before he's allowed on track. Stretching this whole pack out as a long pace line. Justin B forcing his way at the front. The crowd are quite happy that Japan's jammer is back on track. But he has been seen this time by Team Ireland. They are doing everything they can and do take him down on that outside line. Justin B using that opportunity to sneak through almost like a ninja himself and getting that full 5-point pass. There's a cut track there being issued on Zorro, making his way back around to the penalty box, this time in the correct fashion, so he's allowed to sit down straight away. Another 5 points there for Justin B. Japan now purely on the defense. They're using that diamond formation. White solidly holding Justin B, giving him a lot to think about, but he does manage to throw them off balance and skate his way past number 32, Ikagi Soyoro, at the front.
Japan down to three blockers with Gonzi going into the box. Still doing a stellar job of making Justin B really work for those points.
There indeed, Justin B calls it off, allowing Ireland to field a new jammer. They're going to have Electrics Avenue on the jam line for Team Ireland. Zorro for Team Japan still in the penalty box.
Don't forget, folks, if you are enjoying listening to us on the live feed, we would love it if you dropped us a couple of pounds, dollars, zloty, whatever it is your currency. Any money would be good.
Oh!
Use the link on the broadcast page. Split 50-50 between us and the team's travel.
It's absolutely fantastic. Electrics Avenue there, just jumping his way, keeping himself in on that outside line. He is only 19. Can you believe it? Only 19. He did his first ever roller derby bout on his 18th birthday, so he was getting in there as soon as he possibly could. So Electrics Avenue there, picking up 4 points. He has a no pass, no penalty on 1 point there, so not picking up the full 5-point Grand Slam, but adding to Ireland's total. And coming up against a solid 2-all, but he just gives them a nudge, makes his way through again. Zorro, little ninja coming from the penalty box. Ireland caught napping again. They did see him, but weren't able to react quickly enough. Electrics Avenue darting around, realising from the crowd noise that Zorro is back on track and able to call it off before Japan can pick up any more points. Points do currently stand. Team Japan are on 10. Team Ireland are on 189. We've got just over 12 minutes remaining in this half.
That quad skate shot penalty box now empty. First time in a little while. And we have Cuban Whistle Crisis and U2 up to jam now. Japan seeming to favour that shoulder straight off the line with the jammers.
They do. Cuban Whistle Crisis noticing that they'd left the inside line a little bit open, and he managed to toast up, run all the way up that inside line. U2 trying to push his way through that middle, keeping away from the edges as much as he can do. I think Japan's jammers have probably been told, you know, watch that those edges. And he does manage to force his way around, manages to pass around the front of Eddie Knievel there. Sorry, El Araya for Team Ireland. Cuban Whistle Crisis calling it off. He's managed to pick up his 4 points he needed.
He was checking in there with his bench. He's like, I think it was a kind of a, is that a scoring pass? And they were like, yeah, he caught off that jam.
So some good teamwork there from Team Ireland. And again, I think it's been said in quite a lot of the games yesterday, the audience are almost giving the game away for the opposition team on when the jammers break. But it can only reinforce that jammer's love of the sport and their want to go and get some more points.
Justin B and Miyagi Bondi now up to jam. And Bondi is your lead jammer, breaking through that wall of green.
The crowd are absolutely loving it. He's being chased down quite a fast amount here by the jammers. Justin B coming up to a back wall there as Miyagi Bondi is knocked to the outside line. Justin B managing to dart through, picking up 4 points just before Miyagi Bondi can actually call that jam off. But the crowd, disappointed Japan didn't get any points there, but still clapping, loving the fact that Japan are fighting and trying to get control back over this game. I'd like to say a big thank you to people who are listening in, sending Twitters. I've just had a Twitter for me.
Aww.
Oh, how sweet. Thank you so much, Angaroo. I love you too.
Yay.
If you are sending in any Twitters, please do remember to tweet hashtag MRDWC, not at MRDWC. We want to make sure they come through to us. And of course, if you have Instagram, please send us any of your pictures under the MRDWC Instagram. Share your enjoyment of the cup whenever you are, or wherever you are, and they might well make it onto our stream.
Looks like start of that jam, Zoro being sent to the box for a forearms penalty, means that Electrics Avenue is up on a power jam and lead jammer status to boot for Ireland.
And Electrics Avenue pushing his way through the middle of the Japanese blockers there at the front.
And Captain Umasan being sent to the bin as well.
Japan down to just three blockers on track. They have been split up by that Ireland wall. Ireland looking to, cause some offense, but number 113 for Japan, Gonzi, absolutely fantastic, taking out Ireland's jammer on the inside line and being able to recycle him back, slowing down Ireland's possibilities of scoring, and again taking him to that inside line. Electrics Avenue realizing he's been had on that jab.
Yep.
Not happy, but calls it off there, having picked up just the 3 points.
Yeah, Electrics Avenue managing to break past and then coming up against DJ Jack. Japan had him surrounded.
He did indeed.
Must be a little bit terrifying being surrounded by a nation. Zoro still in the box, finishing his minute for that forearms penalty. I play for keeps now, up to jam for Ireland. Score currently sitting 210-10.
I play for keeps, normally playing as a pivot for the Team Ireland team. This is his first time jamming in this bout. Managing to dart his way through for lead jammer and now picking up a 5-point grand slam for Team Ireland. Cuban Whistle Crisis has been sent to the box, so Ireland are on a depleted amount of blockers. Facing up against Zorro, forcing his way around Errol Flynn there at the front. And Team Ireland's I Play for Keeps realising again, I think from the crowd noise, that Japan's jammer had broken through, so he calls it off. Japan still stuck on those 10 points. But as we said, we know they've already won the love of the audience in this tournament.
Absolutely. You two up to jam against the Block Lobster now. You can see just from the stance that these players mean business. They are getting low. Just to let you know, ladies and gentlemen, anyone who is listening and is here in-house, photos with Team Japan at 11:20 a.m. £10, £1.50 of which will go to Team Japan.
And Ireland are also doing photographs at 20 past 2 this afternoon.
Block Lobster getting lead jammer. You two juking it out with Elahira. Lock Lobster with the eyes all over the track, spotting you two coming up for a scoring pass, called off that jam.
We've got a little over 6 minutes left remaining in this half. So 223 points to Ireland, facing up against the 10 points for Japan.
This jam, of course, brought to you by GB EMS, our medics for this tournament, looking after us and keeping us safe.
Oh, indeed, they are the only UK RDA endorsed medical team, so we're so proud to have them here at the Men's Roller Derby World Cup today. Electric Savenue on lead jammer for Team Ireland. He is coming up to the pack on his scoring pass, skipping his way around.
Hasn't clocked that Miyagi-born Dai is up on his scoring pass.
Miyagi-born Dai picking up points here for Team Japan.
That will be 4 points on the board, I believe, for Ireland. For Japan.
Ireland picking up another five-point pass there. Oh, I do apologise, it's a four-point pass. Four-point pass for Electric Avenue. He's looking back to his bench. His bench is saying, no, carry on, carry on. So Miyagi-born Dai still in the pack. He has scored on Team Ireland, but he was recycled back into that pack. Ab Norman again trying to hold him back. As Electric Avenue jumps up that inside line, Miyagi-born Dai. And Electric Avenue, both of them playing up to the crowd after having picked up their points for their respective teams.
You may or may not have seen that. Just a little bit of fancy footwork in the middle by our referee, Fu Man Drew. Nice catch on the nearly falling over there.
I'd like to say hello to the Boomtown Rollers who are tweeting, come on, Ireland. Thank you, Boomtown. I know there's some of you girls and guys in the crowd already here today, but well done to all the guys who are watching at home. Thank you for tweeting in.
Score now, Japan 18, Ireland 2-3-5. Jam is on, U2. And I play for Keeps, who gets out to get lead jammer.
He does indeed. U2 is still at the front, though, facing up just against one blocker, having a tough time, but darting around, managing to knock Lieutenant Dan down. Lieutenant Dan getting a high block in the process. And U2 out, ready to come around for a scoring pass. I play for Keeps, keeping himself nice and low, getting those points for Team Ireland. And Japan's U2 now picking up points as well. Errol Flynn not able to hold U2 back at the front and picking up an out-of-play block at the same time. So both teams getting blockers sent to the box during this. Ireland only have one blocker on track at the moment, facing up against U2.
Mick Dastardly all on his own.
He is. He's now been joined by Cuban Whistle Crisis, I believe, as Ireland's jammer picks up another four-point pass. I play for Keeps, being told to keep going. Ireland want to rack up the points, I believe, on this one. They are, however, allowing Japan to pick up some more points as well. U2 now again on the scoring pass, facing up one-on-one against players. But he has been issued a penalty for blocking out of play. Quite a few jammers having picked that penalty up in this tournament, and a lot of people questioning how that can happen. It is whoever initiates the action. Of course, jammers can play against jammers anywhere on the track, yep. But if you're coming up against a blocker, you cannot initiate a hit against them, a block against them, if they are out of play and you're out of play.
Looks like we had ourselves a jammer switcheroo there. That was so fast I missed it. U2 coming straight out of the box. Doing a beautiful apex jump on turn two. I believe that was a five-point pass for Japan. And we have had a star pass as well.
Yep, Team Ireland didn't have a jammer in play. They had an inactive jammer as the jammer panty had been taken off. Lieutenant Dan taking that panty as the pivot. That was a legal pass, but he wasn't able to use any of the time remaining to pick up any more points for Team Ireland.
Japan now stacking up some points on 30. Team Ireland still way out on the lead with 2-5-2.
Well, we've had a tweet from Victoria White. Team Japan, you may not have won any games, but you have won many hearts.
Aww.
That is so true. They sold out of their merchandise in record time.
Zoro now back up to jam.
He is indeed, Japan. But the jammer panty has fallen off. He has not got the jammer panty, so he is not lead jammer. It has fallen off, and it is here at the back behind Eddie Knievel trying to block it, but Zoro able to find it, picks it back up, and starts to make his way through now.
Eddie Knievel only just making it through for his initial pass.
Justin B picking up lead jammer. He's now on his scoring pass.
My apologies, Justin B. I got mixed up there. But that is a natural Grand Slam. Zoro was still in the pack.
He was indeed. Zoro now scoring. His first pass was counted as an inactive jammer, so he wasn't eligible for lead, but it was passed as an initial pass. I can see him furiously checking that his cover is on as he's going around. Such an unfortunate shame for Team Japan there, wanting to obviously pick up that lead jammer and maximise their amount of points that they could get. They have brought the score up to 34 points, Team Japan, Island on 257. There's only 36 seconds remaining, as I stated it, in this period, this half. So this should possibly be the final jam for this period. Block Lobster number 52 on the jammer line for Team Island. Up against R4, Miyagi Bondi for Team Japan.
Some seriously big hits being thrown within that pack. Block Lobster successful in getting lead jammer.
Miyagi Bondi not too far out behind him. The crowd absolutely loving it. So two jammers now racing their way. The pack is virtually standstill as the jammers make their way to the back there. Ooh. A call off there by Block Lobster. I believe he almost took a hit to the face. I know he put his hand up to his face, calling it off there, but he's signalling to his bench that he's absolutely fine as he comes back. And that was the final jam for that half. Scores are Island 257, Team Japan on 34.
Team Japan managing to rack up 24 of those points in the last 5 or 10 minutes.
Indeed, Team Island getting lead jammer, but not calling off the jams, allowing them to run almost to the full 2 minutes, if not the full 2 minutes, allowing their score to creep up, but also allowing Japan to add, as you said, a lot of points to there.
I can't help but feel that this is one of those games that isn't quite represented by the scoreline. Japan are fighting very, very hard.
Yeah, indeed. Some wonderful work here. We're going to take a timeout. We're going to head you guys back over to the adverts.
See you back in the second half.
Power jam!
We've had quite a few tweets coming through to us as well. If you are tweeting, please remember to send them to hashtag MRDWC. And if we get any that we really like, we'll read them out for you. So we've had a few come through already. Skatey Crusham, MRDWC, distracting me from the housework.
Sorry, Skatey.
Skatey, it's a Saturday. It's a beautiful day. Get your laptop outside. Enjoy the sun. Enjoy the MRDWC.
Also, I'm not really sorry.
No, we're not sorry at all. And we've had Joe Day. It's probably a good job I'm not there after all. There's so many merch stalls, I'd come back a pauper.
Yeah, I must admit I've had to be quite restrictive where I'm taking my money. I'm leaving my bag in the announcer space and I'm taking limited amounts of cash every time I leave.
Indeed. And of course, if you are watching at home and you do think, oh, I need to go and get myself some gear, you can always visit any of the sponsors we've got here. The Quad Skate Shop is Europe's original brick-and-mortar roller derby equipment supplier. Quad Roller Skate Shop has the best selection and most stock of any store on the continent. They've got excellent consultation services only a fellow skater could provide. They've got all your needs covered. They love the game so much that they are sponsoring our penalty box here on the Roller Derby City track and the other track, the Quad Skate Shop track, which the Belgian Germany game takes place.
I spotted a tweet from the MRDC.
MRDWC.
Yes, thank you. Quad Skate Shop track account while we were on break. And it looked like Belgium's fans are there. They are loud and there are pom-poms involved.
Oh, fantastic.
I do hope there's some shots of the crowd when I get to watch those videos back.
Yes, of course. Remember, if you're taking pictures either here at MRDWC or if you're having an MRDWC viewing party, please do send them through to the MRDWC Instagram account. MRDWC, send the pictures. If you've been watching the feed and you've been seeing the adverts coming up, your pictures may very well make it into that feed. So do send them through. We'd love to see what you guys are getting up to.
How cool would that be? Because, I mean, like, we are all right here, right now. Everybody at home listening to us, everybody here in the hall, everybody playing, officiating, everything. We're all part of history. And you could be part of history too on the feed.
can indeed. Laces Lestrade, meant to be writing an essay, but this is much better. Ooh.
Yeah, can't argue with that, really.
Can't argue with it, but make sure that essay gets done Monday morning. If it needs to be in by then, make sure you do it tonight in between the games so you can watch all the finals tomorrow.
Absolutely. You do not want to miss those. As soon as we figure out what the seeding is as the day progresses, we will keep you posted. And as soon as we've got timings for those, we will get you on that as well.
Dozo Domo, go Japan!
Yeah.
Thank you, Dozo Domo. The crowd here are very much behind Team Japan. It's lovely to hear you sending your tweets in as well for Team Japan. And the love again for Team Ireland. They're receiving a lot of love here. Oh, Laces Lestrade is in the library watching Team Ireland Japan, being very sneaky doing that essay.
She's being a library ninja.
She is being a library ninja. Well done, Laces Lestrade. We can't, of course, endorse doing this in a library, but as long as that essay does get done, please carry on watching. And we've started Electrics Avenue for Team Ireland, not picking up lead jammer. Yeah, that was taken by number one, U2. Electrics Avenue now to the back wall. A fantastic jump there by U2, picking up 4 points. The crowd are absolutely loving it. As you can probably tell, I'm saying this with a big smile on my face. Hands in the air after he calls it off. So proud to get those first points in this half. Japan certainly coming back reinvigorated.
Yeah, not going to lie, that was a big smile on his face as he came around this corner to return to his bench.
Mayuki Bondi on the jam line for Team Japan, up against B52, Block Lobster. A very slow start there, both jammers just sizing each other up.
Block Lobster going for that shoulder.
He did indeed, and spotting that inside line was deprived of any Japanese blockers, decides to take his way up there. U2 forcing his way up. Oh no, he has picked up a penalty. Such a shame. The crowd are so behind this Team Japan, but he does pick up a forearms penalty. So a power jam here for Block Lobster.
And that was his first Grand Slam pass of 5 points.
And another 5 points there for Block Lobster. Team Japan now getting another blocker back, bubble, to make up a four wall. Block Lobster being held back quite severely by the three wall there, having a little bit of trouble when he came up against Yumi-san. Again, Yumi-san very solid blocking here today, but Block Lobster able to pick up that five-point Grand Slam pass. Forces his way through with a little bit of offensive play from number seven, Wallbanger. Sadly, Wallbanger getting a penalty for that offensive play, but allowing his jammer through to pick up some more points for Team Ireland.
Looks like Japan just switching out a couple of players for this next jam. Cuban Whistle Crisis starting on a power jam.
Ireland at 277 points, Japan at 38. Ireland only have three blockers on track though, so when Japan's jammer does come out, they will be looking to maximise on that. Cuban Whistle Crisis having quite a lot of work to do there. Again, Ireland taking that passive play, allowing Cuban Whistle Crisis to force his way through. He does pick up lead jammer.
Japan, there was some great wall work, managing to hold back Whistle Crisis for a good 20, 30 seconds.
Mayuki Bondi again, darting his way through that penalty box, catching Ireland unawares. Those ninjas coming out of the penalty box and able to get through on his initial pass. Team Ireland's Cuban Whistle Crisis looking to his bench to see if he needs to call it off. They do give him the action to call it off. But Japan picking up 3 points there as that jam comes to an end. Yumi-san, the blocker for Japan, being sent off there. So again, he's been playing some really solid work, but it does seem that he's picking up more penalties now in the latter half of the game. I know we've only just started the second half, but the latter half of the first period, he was starting to pick up a few penalties there for his blocking.
Yeah, could be that he's getting tired. It's obviously they've had a long journey over here, a long day yesterday, and probably going to be another long day today.
Yep, and these are the first hour-long games that Japan have been playing. U2 on a shoulder power charge after he knocked the other jammer out of the way, but it is Team Ireland picking up lead jammer with Justin B heading round for a pass, scoring pass. Oh, wait, an apex jump there by Japan, but it does not pick up any points for Team Japan. Ireland picking up 3 more points to add to their total. Ireland now on 284 points, with Japan on 41, only 4 minutes and 15 seconds gone in this half.
Zoro and Block Lobster lining up on the jammer line now. Put my teeth back in and see how we get on with this next one.
We thought the Japanese names would be the tricky ones, but with so much of the block word being used in roller derby, it is hard to sometimes get it out. Block Lobster taken down to his knees by Japan, but does manage to power his way through to get lead jammer. Zoro being recycled all the way to the back. It does look like his helmet cover is precariously balanced on his helmet. Japan already having problem with losing the star.
Yep, it is off.
And it is off again. So he is an inactive jammer. Oh, he realizes that his star has come off again. Stops as he comes to the back of that pack to try and retrieve it and replace it. In the meantime, Block Lobster has been recycled all the way to the back and is now facing up against tough wall there from Japan. Zoro continuously checking that his helmet cover is on there. Seems, I think that was a high block there for Elaria from Team Ireland. Zoro making his way through. 4 points there for Team Japan as Block Lobster, knocked to the outside, decides to call off the jam.
That initial pass, of course, even though he didn't have his jammer panty on, counting him as an inactive jammer, it was a legal initial pass. So that one there, he did pick up those 4 points.
He did indeed. And as lead had already been taken, he didn't really lose too much other than having to stop and replace his helmet cover.
His teammates there blocking managed to do great work, holding back Cuban Whistle, Justin B.
We have Cuban Whistle Crisis now on the jam line for Team Ireland. He's up against U2, but Cuban Whistle Crisis picking up lead jammer for Team Ireland. U2 breaking the front of the pack, having a look to see how Cuban Whistle Crisis is doing. And Cuban Whistle Crisis up against the back wall there. Team Japan doing a good job of holding him back there. Some really good recycling. Japan's blockers making their way around to the front once they've been passed aside. Ireland only picking up 2 points on that pass and having to call it before U2 can come around and pick up any points for Team Japan. So Japan's blockers really settling into their blocking formation here.
Most definitely. It almost seems like that first half was kind of a warm-up, getting into a rhythm. They have managed to really kind of lock together, and they're really gelling as a team.
They are indeed. Mayugi Bondai on the jam line for Team Japan. Quite a slow start. Electrics Avenue trying to shoulder him off the line. He darts the Japan blockers to the outside and the inside. Both jammers now at the front of the pack. Electrics Avenue just darting up that inside line with a little bit of help from his own blockers. Mayugi Bondai taken down on a heavy fall, but he is back up, checks that the star is on his helmet before making his way round for his scoring pass. Electrics Avenue having a look at the jam referee. I think he was trying to call it with just one hand. He wasn't really calling it. The jammer referee didn't allow that as a call off initially, but once that they had sort of a recommunication with that call off.
Yeah, you do, of course, to call off the jam, you do need both hands tapping those hips.
We got Rachel Hunter on the Twitter feed loving the stealth of Ninjapan. They are indeed little Japanese ninjas. They are absolutely fantastic. Coming out from the penalty box, picking themselves back up after these hits to the outside or down, showing off a lot of their skills. And of course, as we said, starting to pick up so much.
You too, taking the rhino over the unicorn in this derby game, getting lead jammer status.
He's back round now for a scoring pass.
Justin B only just making his way round after his initial pass. I play for keeps, not quite able to stop him.
You two playing up to the crowd there before waiting, calling off that jam, and the crowd absolutely loving the fact that Japan got to control that game, lose no points to Team Ireland in that jam, and take their score up to 49 points.
Team Ireland now on 295, just over 21 minutes to go. I think that may have been the first jam we've had that Ireland haven't scored.
I do believe, apart from the 0-0 jam that we had previously, it's the first time Japan have scored more than Ireland in a jam. Lieutenant Dam now on the jammer line, picking up lead jam for Team Ireland.
Zoro back up to jam for Team Japan. Zoro also already on 5 majors.
He is indeed, but he's going to be making sure his panty is on. I think that's the first of his priorities. Lieutenant Dan picking up a nice, easy pass through there and calling it, having picked up 4 points for Team Ireland. Team Ireland now on 299 points, with Japan on 49 points.
And Team Japan are calling an official, a team timeout, my apologies.
They are indeed. Now, with this being a full 1 hour long bout, the clock does stop for their team
yes.
timeout. Yesterday, if you're watching the feed, the timeouts, the clock did not stop. It was half an hour regardless. So they do get their chance to have a break. And the crowd are really behind them on this break. We can hear the Nin Japan chant from the audience.
And from our vantage point, we can see that Sho, who is not skating today, is doing a little bit of a booty wiggle to the crowd.
He is
getting them really riled
up. Definitely. He's on the bench. He is still a rostered skater, taking a bow to the crowd, bless him. He is a rostered skater. He is on the bench for moral support as well as further support for Team Japan. And, of course, he's doing a wonderful job all the way through today of keeping crowd spirits high. Fantastic sportsmanship there from the injured player. You two almost signalling the start of the jam there. He wanted to run off on that whistle. That wasn't the start of the jam. So now I Play for Keeps is keeping a close eye on him. Both jammers lined up right next to each other.
You two with a massive shoulder there. I Play for Keeps being taken off on the inside. You two is your lead jammer for Japan.
Yeah, fantastic work there from Bubble for Team Japan to allow you two to get that lead jam. I Play for Keeps knocked to the inside. Both jammers now coming back round, trying to score some points. You two darting his way around, keeping that inside line. He picks up a no pass, no penalty, but takes 3 points for Team Japan there. Ireland also picking up 3 points on that jam. Ireland breaking now the 300 point barrier on 302 to Japan's 52. 20 minutes remaining in this half.
Maegi Bondi up to jibe for Japan against Electrics Avenue for Ireland. And Maegi Bondi, lead jammer for Japan. That's the second jam in the row.
It is indeed. Ireland struggling with only the three blockers there to maintain a full pack. And Japan able to hold Ireland off to a nil point jam there. Fantastic work. Their blockers rushing to make sure they've got that jam line. So much so they send on five just to make sure they've got it covered so they can take the back ball there. This next jam has been brought to you by GB EMS. Providers of event medical cover and ambulance transport across the UK. They are sponsoring the pivot line. Thank you to GB EMS. And it's Zorro for Team Japan facing up against Justin B. Both of them trying to force their way through their opposition blockers. Justin B managing to do so, swooping around his own wall and picking up lead jammer before Zorro can make his way around that front wall for Team Ireland. Justin B now up against, knocked to the inside line by Umi-san. Again, solid blocking from Umi-san, number 7, Japan's blocker, having a fantastic game here today.
Absolutely.
I think we've both mentioned how solid he is and how good he is at just holding back and knocking off Team Ireland's blockers and jammers.
Yep, Team Ireland now calling a team timeout.
Julia Redgate states on Twitter, that was the quickest she's ever hung out her laundry. Go Team Ireland. Hoping you've
fantastic.
Got some fantastic weather there. It is beautiful here. I know we're inside, but it is a glorious day here in Birmingham where we are hosting the Men's Roller Derby World Cup.
Now, just while Ireland have this team timeout and they regroup, we just want to let you know the Men's Roller Derby Association would like to wish all the teams in the Men's Roller Derby World Cup the best of luck this weekend. The MRDA is the international governing body for men's flat track roller derby and wants you to join them in the growing world of men's roller derby. For more information about joining and the benefits of being part of the MRDA, visit them at mensrollerderbyassociation.com or send inquiries to info@mensrollerderbyassociation.com.
Yeah, we'd like to say a big thank you. Obviously, we are playing under the 2013 WFTDA rule set. WFTDA and MRDA working in very close conjunction for the tournaments, especially tournaments like this. So big thank you to both of those organisations.
Yeah, we couldn't do this without them.
We couldn't indeed. Cuban Missile Crisis, and you two are the jammers for this bout. You two managing to take towards the front as Cuban Missile Crisis is held at the back. You two picking up lead jammer. Cuban Missile Crisis is right hot on his tail. Little bit of jammer on jammer action. Cuban Missile Crisis a little bit stronger on that first hit. You two on the second one. Both jammers wanting the points. Both jammers picking up the points again. Jammer on jammer, so close to each other as they come out. You two signalling to Cuban Missile Crisis with the finger points, finger guns there. And again, both jammers coming through. You two picking up much better fairing. Wow. 4 points there as Team Ireland's Cuban Missile Crisis taken all the way to the back by the Japanese blockers. Immense working again. Yumi San providing and proving himself to be a fantastic blocker.
That. I got to say it yesterday, I'm going to say it again, the crowd goes wild.
You two absolutely, astoundingly getting another positive jam over Team Ireland. The crowd know this, the crowd are fantastic behind them. Ireland's blockers, realising Japan have been taking the advantage, diving for that jam line to make sure they get it on this occasion.
Now, Japan managing to pick up 13 points in that jam, Ireland only 6. So that I'd call that a win in that jam
that
for
Japan.
That is
definitely a win for Team Japan. Ireland's blockers managing to take Mikey Bondi out to that outside line. Block Lobster forcing up against and managing to get around the outside of the Japanese blockers. Again, Ireland desperately wanting that back line, and it seems to be proving in their favour here. Mikey Bondi had been taken back by Lieutenant Dam. Block Lobster knocked down to the ground and having to sort of reassess the situation. Gonzi providing that big block there, but he is now through. Block Lobster picking up a 5-point grand slam over Team Japan.
Miyagi Bondi pushing his way through. Lieutenant Dam still got him in sight. Wow.
A big hit there from Lieutenant Dam. The crowd felt it as much as Miyagi Bondi, but Miyagi Bondi, I think, takes the worst wear for it. Recycled all the way to the back, but he is given a reprieve. Block Lobster calling that jam off there at the end. Scores now stand at 318 to Ireland and a fantastic score of 65 to Japan. After that previous jam, they managed to rack up quite a few points.
Now, I have only just noticed, me being a very observant announcer, Team Japan don't have pivot panties.
They don't, no. They are going jammer only, so they cannot do any star passes. I don't know whether this is a tactical decision or a financial decision or due to the amount of players that they're doing a rotation of just jammers.
Zoro now out of the pack, chasing down. Believe that is Justin B.
It is Justin B. Zoro, as he exited the front of the pack, desperately checking that he still had his jammer panty on his helmet, which he did, and his teammates confirming he does still have it on there. Japan not picking up any points on that pass, but still the crowd behind them. Steph B on Twitter, all she says is, woohoo, we're right behind you, Steph B.
Absolutely.
There have been many times where I've actually had to stop talking because I'm smiling so much that I think I'll start laughing. This is such a great game. You two on the jam line for Team Japan against I Play For Keeps. I Play For Keeps trying to find that inside line that he had so easy last time. Not so easy this time. And you two managing to go around the outside, picking up lead jammer.
I Play For Keeps taking a beating in the pack from Team Japan.
Oh, and Japan trying to chase him down. That's number 113. Gonzi again. Gonzi and Gonzi and Umisan. A formidable pair up for Team Japan.
They are both on track right now, they are doing some beautiful two-wall work.
They are. I Play For Keeps having a really, really tough time. Umisan and Gonzi, when they're paired up, I don't think anybody will get through there. We've got just over 14 minutes left on this bout. Ireland on 324 points, Japan on 67. Don't forget to tweet through to us, hashtag MRDWC. If they're interesting or funny, they'll get read out by us. Electrics Avenue on the jam line up against Zorro for Team Japan. Both of them were trying to worm their way through. Oh, Electrics Avenue being taken out by Team Japan. Recycled all the way to the back. There is a no-pack situation. Zorro is at the front. Not sure if he's being signaled off. He isn't, so he carries on fighting and picks up lead jammer. A little bit of confusion there. Again, double-checking his helmet cover is on before making his way around for a scoring pass.
I think Zoro's going to develop a complexion about that jammer panty. Some fancy footwork, pulls off his feet, double-checking his panty. Picks up a few points and calls off that jam.
Yeah, Electrics Avenue managing to sneak through while Zoro's being held up by Team Island. So Electrics Avenue picking up points there for Team Island as well.
Japan now up to 70 points against Ireland's 328. Just under 13 minutes left to go here.
Is that Purple's Azical watching the game on Instagram. Fantastic.
Wow.
So saying good luck, guys. I'm assuming that's for all of the players here today. No team specified, so good luck to everyone. Is that I Play for Keeps taking lead jammer?
No, that is Lieutenant Dam taking
Lieutenant
lead jammer.
Lieutenant Dam, fantastic.
You too, first time in a couple of jams, still fighting his way through the pack, unsuccessful at that lead jammer. Blocking out a play penalty goes to...
That's El Haraya.
Thank you.
For Team Island. Lieutenant Dam finding himself behind U2 as U2 comes around for a scoring pass. Calls it off. Just 4 points there for Team Island.
Now, I mentioned this a couple of times yesterday about the sweat on the track that some people are slipping over. As El Haraya went to the track, you can see there is a streak of snail trail where his leg dragged across the floor.
We can see just behind the shot there that you saw of Cho, there is a lovely little slide into the penalty box, which may cause problems for skaters who are entering the penalty box. Remember, if you do manage to clutter, move the penalty box to the extent that it can affect the NSOs, that can give you another penalty. Yep. So skaters are going to have to be really careful with the moisture on the track due to the heat here in the venue today.
That is I Play for Keeps breaking out to get lead jammer status over Zorro, who takes a massive hit, recovers quite quickly. It is up against that wall of Irish blockers.
Zorro being twisted around and around as I Play for Keeps gingerly makes his way through. He was holding his arms up there as if to try and stop himself from being blocked, but didn't face too much opposition there. Zorro again twisting, darting, trying to work his way around Team Island. Team Island trying being steady and holding him back. Mick Dastardly doing a great job there of some booty blocking.
And is it Sean Brennan?
It's Kian.
Sean Brennan taking him off and taking him back. Errol Flynn recycling as well.
And some offensive play there by Team Japan, trying to get the outside line, but Kian Brennan again taking Zorro down and out on the outside line, allowing Team Island to pick up more points. El Araya making his way back onto the track just before I Play for Keeps calling it, so Ireland will have a full four wall for this lineup.
And it looks like Team Japan have called a second timeout. Now, I want to talk to you guys once again about Fast Girl Skates. Their knowledgeable staff represents all facets of roller derby. WFTDA, USARS, MRDA, JRDA, and Banktrack. They can relate and they have what you need. We've got the largest selection of skates and gear for everyone, men, women, juniors. It is about you.
And remember, if you're enjoying what you're hearing here on the broadcast, please don't forget, we will appreciate any donations you can give in any currency that you have. So please do donate over to us. It is split. Any donations are split 50-50 between us and the team's travel funds. So if you do donate to us, it's not just us taking the money. We are making sure that the teams do receive that. A lot of teams have traveled a long distance to get here today. The link is on the broadcast page. We'd like to say a big thank you to Laura Kenny, who has given us a donation. So thank you ever so much. Follow in her footsteps on that broadcast page and donate through to the MRDWC.
Thanks, guys. Really appreciate this. Right, team timeout is complete. Score sitting on 346-70. It looks like we have number one, U2, up to jam for Japan.
Against Cuban Whistle Crisis for Team Island.
That looks like total carnage on track there.
Ab Norman taking down U2 on that inside. Both of them going down and out, but Team Island managing to recycle U2 back In the meantime, Cuban Missile Crisis picking up lead jammer. U2 is now released, but Cuban Missile Crisis already at that back wall, facing up again against that solid blocking combination. Gonzi almost immovable, let alone impassable there. Cuban Missile Crisis calling it off, a 0-0 jam there. So Japan doing some fantastic defensive work. U2 staying on that jam line for Team Japan. He's having fun. He wants to stay in the action.
He's like, hey, I'm fresh. I'm good. I'm going to stay on.
He's up against Justin B for Team Ireland.
Just 9 3/4 minutes left of this game. U2 bullying his way through. Justin B being taken off and recycled.
Yep, Gonzi taking him out, but Gonzi going down as well, questioning that call on the referees. But of course, if he has gone down, Justin B can come on in front of him, which he does. He is not lead jammer, however, because he did not pass him legally.
Yeah, that's our jam ref indicating the no pass, no penalty. And U2 is your lead jammer right now.
Lieutenant Dan being sent to the penalty box for a forearms. U2 being signalled by the crowd to call it off. He hasn't done so yet. He wants those points as Justin B forces his way through, picks up the points. U2 making his way around the outside, also picking up points for Team Japan. Japan and Ireland's blockers now settling themselves in. Japan taking that back line as Justin B comes up, bursting up against Bubble and Gonzi as U2 faces up against Kian Brennan, who's been so good again as he does, knocking the skaters to the outside line. He does receive a penalty, a back block penalty for this. Justin Ballsdeep now back round at the back as U2 picks up 5 points for Team Japan.
I believe that
four points for Team Japan. And calls it there.
The crowd are going nuts for U2 to call that jam, but I think he was desperately wanting to just rack up those points.
Yep, team timeout again to Team Ireland. I think they're trying to reassess the situation. They had such a strong start at the beginning of the bout. Japan seemed to have come back from the second half really refreshed.
Yeah.
Team Ireland taking a second timeout now to try and reassess their situation. They have already fielded Electrics Avenue on the jam line. Also with Block Lobster and Ab Norman, their team captain. And they do have two players in the box, so they already know their next lineup.
Yep.
But the team timeout is for the remainder of the players to get their heads a bit fresher and try and come back with the amount of pizzazz that Japan basically have brought for the whole bout, but especially in this second half.
There's some real sort of sass tactics. I trademarked this yesterday. There's some real sassistics coming up for Japan right now.
There is indeed. Whilst we've got a short break, we'd like to again just remind you the Pivot Line is being sponsored by GB EMS. They are the UK, the only UK RDA endorsed medical team, and we are so thankful for them being here today.
That they did, of course, look after Raven Buster yesterday and Show, and they made sure they got the treatment that they needed.
They did indeed, and thank you to GB EMS. They're sat right next to us here at the announcer's table.
Looks like we've got Gummy Bear and Birdie.
Also next to us is Robert Rodriguez, who is over on the Japanese feed. If you've been listening to us and you'd like to hear a different voice, you're more than welcome to. You can dart over to the alternate language feed and to hear it in Japanese.
You can get all the names pronounced correctly as well.
Most probably. We have Mayuki Bondi just breaking out his not lead jammer. That has already been given to Electrics Avenue, who's now on a scoring pass. Being forced to the outside again by Umi-san. Solid blocking. Electrics Avenue does make his way around. Checks over to his bench. His bench tells him to carry on. He's only picked up the 4 points there.
Miyagi Bondi coming up on the outside, taking a huge hit from Lieutenant Dam. And Dam taking him right back around the track.
In the meantime, that gives Electrics Avenue the space and opportunity to work his way through, picking up a 5 point Grand Slam for Team Ireland. Ireland probably hoping to break that 400 point mark not too soon, in the not too distant future.
Yeah. Both Electrics Avenue and Miyagi are having trouble getting through.
An out of play being called. Japan's number seven, Umi-san, just double checking it was him that they was being called on. Some of them thinking that it had actually been the end of the game, the amount of whistles that were being played. Electrics Avenue darting his way around, picking up another 5 point pass. Mogi Bondi at the back, trying to face up against the the blockers there. I've just been reprimanded. I do apologise. It has been many, many years since I lived in Ireland, and I've been pronouncing Kian as my mother would pronounce it, and it's Kian.
We do apologise.
I'm so sorry, Kian. I'm sure he will actually come over and have a go at me later as well. So it's Kian Brennan. He is doing some sterling blocking for Team Ireland. Really solid at knocking the jammer to the outside line and then recycling them back. Zorro on the line for Team Japan. Almost going in really low there. And Cuban Whistle Crisis trying to take that inside line while Zorro's head was down. Zorro does scoot through, doing a fantastic side surfing on that inside line to get through. But Cuban Whistle Crisis lead jammer spins his way through the pack whilst Japan's blockers are being sent to the box and picking up the points there for Team Ireland. No points for Team Japan.
With just under 6 minutes left of this game, we have Japan sitting now on 80 points, I believe that is.
81.
Thank you. Team Ireland on 386.
You two up to jam for Team Japan against Justin B. These guys have faced off a couple of times in this bout already. Both teams very depleted on blockers. Japan only have two. Ireland deciding to take the pivot line. It's sponsored by GBEMS, so a pivot line start here. You two trying to take the outside whilst the blockers were distracted, but it does favour Justin B. Justin B lead jammer, but you two not too far, only about a quarter lap behind him as they race round. The blockers almost stand still whilst the jammers approach. Justin B calling it off as he's pushing. Not picking up any points though, a nil-nil pass for Justin B. So no points on the board for either jammer there.
Nil point.
Oh, are you on the alternate language feed as well?
Yeah, totally. Yeah, yeah.
Just over 4.5 minutes left remaining in this bout. Ireland 386 to Japan's 81. You two on the line for Japan, sorry, against Ab Norman, the team captain for Team Ireland, picking up lead jammer.
Gonzi blocking on his own. Still managed to clear most of the island wall to make some space for you two on the inside.
He has now been joined by Gundam. So two blockers for Team Japan as they face up against Ab Norman. Ab Norman using his long legs to dart around. Oh, it seems like there's something on the track there. You two picking up some debris or something from the track, moving it out of the way as he comes back round. But Ab Norman calling it before you two can pick up any points. Oh, there's a handshake there between the two jammers. So obviously something had fallen onto the track. Ab Norman thanking you two for putting health and safety in front of points there.
Most definitely. Looks like we have another tweet from Filthy Delphia. Team Japan are basically the Jamaican bobsleigh team of the weekend. That's
that is
fantastic.
So true. I have heard that quote a number of times, actually. So, yes, if you've seen the film, of which we shall not name, probably for legal reasons, yeah.
Possibly, yeah.
Team Japan are doing a great venture in getting the crowd behind them. Lieutenant Dan, the jammer for Team Ireland, he has picked up lead. Double-checking his helmet panty, Zorro is broken free of the pack. Lieutenant Dan, however, picking up 4 points, looking towards his bench and calling it there. So Ireland now not allowing Japan to score once they've taken the lead. Whereas they did towards the end of the first half, they were trying to rack up the points. Now they've got that advantage and they've got a high number of points. They're stopping Japan from getting any further points. Japan able to get the back line here. I saw a knee start almost, but that was saving the back line. You two up against Justin B.
Wow, knee start. That's going back a bit.
Showing my age. And you two pushing Justin B to one side, trying to work his way around the opposite side and breaking free for lead jammer Team Japan.
Electric Avenue follows him down with a hip check. Doesn't quite connect. You two is still out about a quarter of the track ahead of Justin B.
And again, a slow-moving pack. They are mobile. You two taking some opposition.
Wow.
Some fantastic offensive work there. I believe that was Yubisan. Again, opening up that inside line. A nice, easy jump through. Big smiles from the whole of Team Japan, but you two's is the biggest. Some points on the board there for Team Japan. Team Ireland on 397. They're looking to break the 400-point mark. Japan on 85.
1 minute 45 left. Zorro and
Cuban whistle crisis.
Whistle.
Indeed, Cuban whistle crisis. I think that's a play on a referee name, potentially. Zorro trying to take the outside line there whilst Cuban whistle crisis going for the inside. Both of them struggling. It's been a while since we've seen it take this long, but Cuban whistle crisis benefiting from Team Japan's block has been taken down to the floor. Zorro taking that long outside line double, checking his helmet cover and coming back round for his scoring pass. Cuban whistle crisis has hit the back of the pack, manages to push his way through, pushes his hips round to the back, getting a little cheer from the audience there as he picks up the points for Team Ireland.
Yeah, not going to lie, that was a little bit of a frantic calling it off. It's like, now.
Please, he could probably hear, feel and see the jammer behind him. Japan's jammers making sure they're coming around as quick as they can. Yeah. Ireland have broken the 400-point scoreline. They are on 401 to Japan's 85.
Block Lobster now up against U2. Block Lobster getting very low. U2 just going to use his strength and size.
We are into the last few remaining seconds. 30 seconds left on the period clock. This jam will be the last jam, I believe.
U2 getting called for a cut track there. Lieutenant Dan forcing that cut,
which is giving Block Lobster a power jam. I do believe Ireland will run this now all the way through to the end.
And that's the first 5-point pass there for Block Lobster. All eight blockers on track. Team Japan walling up tight at the front there.
Team Ireland not using that passive offence. Keane Brennan going in for some offensive play there on the outside, managing to push Team Japan to out of play. Block Lobster only having to face up against Ikage Soro and number 113 Gonzi. Does manage to break through and is now back through for a second pass. Lieutenant Dam doing a heavy hit, taking down Bubble. Lieutenant Dam being given a penalty for that hit.
Yes.
But it has given Ireland's jammer Block Lobster the chance to get through. The pack have moved forwards ever so slowly.
First time in a while I've seen a pack pace on a power jam.
Indeed. Keane Brennan trying to take that outside line, but Block Lobster taken to the outside by Bubble, pulls it off there. That will be the end. Our unofficial scores are 416 to Team Ireland, 85 to Team Japan.
Do you know what? I think that is absolutely phenomenal, considering that Team Japan was sat on 10 points for easily the first 20 minutes.
They did.
To have racked up an additional 75 in about 40 minutes, that is fantastic, because Team Ireland was so strong, so organised, really, as we say, on the ball with those reformations. And just their pack and track awareness, second to none.
Indeed. Team Japan only bringing 11 players over. And, of course, they had Sho injured. So they were only playing with 10 against Ireland's 14.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for joining us on the Roller Derby City track. We will see you later on in the day for more of this wonderful Roller Derby action.
We'll take you over to the studio.
Won all of our hearts here today, and we'll play again later on, more on that in a moment. I've got to say, Team Japan, how much have they learned in the last like 12 hours? It's incredible the way these guys have absorbed the game. They've come on strong, and it's just, I think it says everything you need to know about the growth of this sport, the growth of men's derby worldwide. A brilliant message going out. Andy, they've just lost that game, but that's not the last time we're going to see Japan today, is it?
That's correct. So despite losing that, they're going to be playing again. They're going to be playing the losers of the game that's on the quad skate shop track at the moment, which is Belgium against Germany. So Japan will be playing again today. They'll be playing at 4:30 GMT. Ireland, who took the victory there, again cementing a great performance they've had so far, will play the winners of Belgium against Germany at the moment. Just looking over there, I think that's reaching half-time at the moment with Germany in the lead.
Of course, you can go over to the Quad Skate Shop track and have a look at that. They're just coming up into their half-time now, but they will go back to that action. I think actually it's a good point to highlight Team Ireland as well. Kind of an unsung hero actually coming through here. Some great performances. I think you said it yourself, they were a bit unlucky on the draw yesterday. I think they've got to be really proud of a 400 points there. Even against a team that perhaps lacks a little bit of the tournament experience like Japan, they put in a very, very confident, very, very competent performance. So kudos to Team Ireland as well. Thank you very, very much for sticking with us. Like I say, you can tune into the Quad Skate Shop track and you'll be able to watch the action going on there, which will be the end of the Belgium-Germany bout. Coming up on Royal Derby City next, we have got...
Finland against Sweden.
Finland against Sweden. That'll be coming up in a short while. But before we go to that, here's a few ads. Thanks for sticking with us here at the Men's Royal Derby World Cup 2014.